Go green! The Jets? No way. I'm rooting for a green earth. I'm Jenny Spencer, and welcome to Brookdale Newsmakers. Today's newsmaker is Jim Burkett, member of the Cats Committee, here to tell us about their plan to give Brookdale a more beautiful environment with longevity. Hi, Jim.
Hello.
Thank you for being here.
Yeah, it's my pleasure.
Tell us, what does the acronym CATS stand for?
CATS stands for the College Action Team for Sustainability. It's kind of a big fancy word for go green.
Okay. So can you tell us about, I know Earth Day and Arbor Day have just passed. Mm-hmm. So can you tell us about the big events for those?
Right. Everybody knows Earth Day was April 22nd and Arbor Day was April 24th. So as part of our committee, we decided to have like kind of an Earth Day, Arbor Day kickoff where we planted 100 trees in a saplings in a nursery area on campus to kind of help the college go towards a much sustainable project.
Okay, so those trees, are they going to be, they're going to stay on campus?
Yes. Right now, they're in buckets in behind the Children's Learning Center. And in 2 years, when they're big enough, we're going to transplant them around campus. And then we're going to plant another 100 back in the same spot. So we're going to have like a nursery area where every 2 years, we're going to have another 100 trees on campus.
Oh, that's a good way to build sustainability.
Absolutely.
All right, so the CATS members, about 15 of you guys, it includes faculty, administration, staff, volunteers, mm-hmm. students. Tell us why it's so important of having people from all different subject areas in the group.
Well, what we're trying to do is try and expand our horizons to the entire college. So it really wouldn't make sense if just the environmental people got together. We have people from like dining services, like I said, administration, faculty from, you know, everything from respiratory health, English, political science, and everybody has their own different opinion about how things should go, and they're trying to kind of bring their expertise to the table. So some things that we wouldn't think about in the environmental side, somebody else is going to bring to the table as well.
Okay, that's a great idea. Now, yeah. Can you tell us about some of the initiatives that they've done, the members have done other things?
Well, we started about a year and a half ago, and we were charged by President Burnham to create a more sustainable Brookdale. That includes, with the new Big Four project, they're doing what's called LEED certification, which is basically a higher set of environmental standards for the new buildings. We're also trying to get rid of styrofoam in the cafeteria, so we've eliminated those styrofoam trays. We have a program to recycle ink toner cartridges, and we've also trying to eliminate the one-use flyers that people stick in mailboxes around campus and hanging up. So we're trying to get people to use more sustainable ways of marketing and things like that as well.
Okay, so you mentioned the styrofoam.
Yes.
Around campus, there are several ways for the Go Green initiative to help support. For example, choosing paper plates over the plastic or the styrofoam. Why is that important?
Well, basically, styrofoam is just a bunch of little plastic balls kind of cemented together, and it just does not biodegrade. And what we're trying to do is reduce the amount of trash output we have from Brookdale as well. And it's important, you know, we're a college, so we're trying to teach people to not make those choices in their daily lives, too, to try and use more sustainable products. You know, paper is obviously more biodegradable than plastics, or we're trying to reuse things that that can be reused.
Okay. So now, as with most committees and most programs around Brookdale, people usually put out paper flyers and post up things on walls. I've never seen anything for the Go Green initiative on paper. Right. Tell me, how can we find more information about it?
Well, we were, you know, one of our first tasks was to try and eliminate, you know, some of the excess waste. And actually, one of the things we did was we reduced the amount of those college catalogs that everyone gets distributed. So we're also trying to reduce the amount of the flyers that are handed out. And we've, as a committee, decided that we're not going to use paper to advertise our programs. So a lot of our information's on our website and also through emails. We have an Angel page that's like the online shell, so we can all communicate through that as well.
Okay. Now, you mentioned email. That's the best way to reach you guys.
Yeah, the committee has cats@brookdalecc.edu.
Okay.
And we have our webpage. It's linked right to the main homepage at Brookdale. If there's a link that says Sustainable Brookdale.
Great.
And it has all you need to know about our information.
Thank you so much for being here with us, Jim.
Thank you.
And thank you for joining us for Brookdale Newsmakers. Today's guest was Jim Burkett, member of the CATS Committee. For more information or visit us on demand, visit www.brookdalecc.edu.